we as a committee have decided that we will summon the county executive of Migori County, led by Governor Okoth Obado, to appear before the Senate at the risk of being escorted here by the police if he fails to appear, and at the risk of being prosecuted criminally for violating lawful summons to appear before the Senate. We are making the decision that when the governor appears, he will first have to explain two things. One, the governor's or the county government of Migori's failure to submit documents and information to Parliament as directed by law. Two, the failure of the governor and the county executive to submit documents and information to the auditor in response to the audit queries. So the summons first will give the Migori County executive and the governor an opportunity to be heard before we mete out punishment. Two, it will also give Migori County government and the governor an opportunity now to appear before Senate and account for public monies.
And a failure by a person to give answers to the raised questions by the Auditor General is actually suspicious, Mr. Chairman. Why couldn't this particular person bring documents, answers in advance, so that he could peruse them, and when he comes, he simplifies our work? So the fact that this man has ordered the documents is another suspicion in this particular line of our duty. His failure also to appear with avoidable circumstances raises more questions than answers, Mr. Chair. And I want to repeat that, Chair, I've gone through this document. When we were given, right from yesterday, the Auditor General report, the issues that have been raised are grievous. Even wonder how Migori County is still operating with such irregularities. A county that has every aspect of financial expenditure, Mr. Chairman, is irregular in a way. You can even see irregular payments of legal fees amounting up to 1.5 billion. And when you correspond with the cases that they were handling, Mr. Chairman, they are petty cases that could be even be resolved through what I would say through alternative conflict resolution strategies. But they have engaged court and paid a lot of money. I want to tell the people of Migori how much 1 billion that has gone to simple cases in court could have helped to dig boreholes, could have improved health facilities during this particular time, could have built several ECD classrooms and the rest. So abuse of public funds in this county raises a lot of questions. And I want to say, Chair, that this particular Senate committee should be hard on this particular governor. One, as the legal clerk has said, that we've got that authority as the Senate to enforce several measures to make sure that this person adheres to the particular requirements by this Senate.